As we enter 2026, the Chengdu J-20 Mighty Dragon is no longer simply known as China's fifth-generation stealth fighter jet. This platform has evolved into a visible symbol of the transformation of Chinese air doctrine, from merely catching up with Western technology to setting new standards in modern air warfare. Chinese military authorities now openly classify the J-20 as a 5.5-generation aircraft, a term reflecting its combination of stealth capabilities, advanced sensors, artificial intelligence, and unmanned combat system control. This transformation is primarily underpinned by two key pillars, the fully developed WS-15 engine and the J-20's role as a command center for combat drones. The entry into full operational status of the WS-15Mi engine marks a crucial turning point in the history of the J-20 program. For years, the engine issue was the single most significant gap frequently highlighted by Western analysts. Now, this gap has been effectively closed, cementing China's military jet engine technology independence. With an estimated thrust of 180 to 190 kilonewtons, the WS-15 delivers a significant performance leap. This increase impacts not only maximum speed but also maneuverability at high altitudes and with a full internal payload. The J-20 can now maintain combat energy for longer periods in intense air combat scenarios. True supercruise capability is another strategic advantage. Flying supersonic without afterburners at Mach 1.3 to Mach 1.5 allows the J-20 to penetrate enemy territory with a significantly reduced radar and infrared signature. This directly enhances the effectiveness of long-range stealth missions in vast regions like the Western Pacific. In terms of survivability, the reduced heat signature through new nozzle designs and high-temperature resistant materials makes the J-20 increasingly difficult to lock onto by modern IRST systems. In next-generation air warfare, this thermal superiority is often the deciding factor in life and death beyond visual range. The two-seat J-20 variant marks a fundamental shift in China's approach to air combat. The aircraft is no longer simply an individual fighter, but rather a flying command node coordinating multiple unmanned platforms in the air. The presence of the J-20 in operational units demonstrates that this concept has passed the experimental phase. The rear seat of the J-20 serves as a mission control center, where the operator can direct the maneuvers, sensors, and weapons of the GJ-11 Sharp Sword stealth drone. On a single mission, the J-20 can control up to 6 drones, creating a numerical advantage without risking the lives of additional pilots. In addition to its offensive role, the J-20 also serves as an electronic warfare hub. With advanced jamming and spoofing capabilities, the aircraft can degrade enemy radar networks, opening safe air corridors for manned aircraft and other drones. This makes the J-20 a key asset in the early stages of a large-scale conflict. The integration of an AI co-pilot further enhances this role. The artificial intelligence system helps sort through vast amounts of sensor data, reducing the crew's cognitive load and providing real-time tactical recommendations. In fast-paced combat conditions, the presence of AI can be the difference between a good decision and a fatal error. From a quantitative perspective, the J-20 is now entering a phase that is most concerning for its competitors. Production estimates through early 2026 indicate a production run of 350 to 400 units, a figure that marks China's transition to numerical dominance in the heavy-duty stealth jet category. The operational deployment of the J-20 also demonstrates a clear strategic focus. Permanent deployments in the Southern and Eastern Theater Commands ensure a consistent stealth air presence in two of the most geopolitically sensitive regions. This presence is not only military, but also serves as a political signal and strategic deterrent. High production speeds are enabled by the implementation of automation-based digital factories. With the use of precision robotics and intelligent manufacturing systems, China is able to maintain quality while increasing quantity. A production target of up to 100 units per year provides significant flexibility in maintaining long-term combat readiness. In the context of modern conflict, quantity is often as important as quality. The large J-20 fleet allows China to maintain sustained air pressure, even in protracted war scenarios with high attrition rates. The J-20's avionics upgrades reflect the modern, information-centric air warfare philosophy. The latest version of the Type 1475 AESA radar not only increases detection range, but also improves resistance to electronic jamming. This radar serves as the J-20's primary eye in an increasingly dense electronic warfare environment. The integration of ultra-long-range missiles such as the PL-17 and PLACE 21 expands the J-20's role from fighter jet hunter to strategic asset hunter. With a range of hundreds of kilometers, the J-20 can attack tankers and a WACS aircraft without approaching the enemy's primary air defense zone, weakening the enemy's combat network at its roots. The J-20's cockpit has also been redesigned to support high-intensity combat. A holographic cockpit and helmet-mounted 360-degree display provide near-universal situational awareness. The pilot is no longer simply flying the plane, but managing a complex combat system like a battlefield commander. This comprehensive avionics and weapons package makes the J-20 a platform that is not only lethal but also highly adaptable. In the ever-changing landscape of air warfare, this flexibility is the key to long-term superiority. From the perspective of defense analysts in 2026, the J-20 is no longer just an ambitious project, but a fully-fledged air force. China is considered to have closed much of the technological gap with the United States, particularly in terms of engines, sensors, and unmanned systems integration. However, the biggest challenge for the West now is no longer whether the J-20 is on par with the F-22, but rather how to counter hundreds of J-20s operating alongside thousands of combat drones in a unified air warfare ecosystem. In the Pacific skies, a new era of air warfare appears to have truly begun.